Hello children, myself Balamani, TGT Mathematics of TSMS Jagdevpur. The topic I am going to present today is quadrilaterals of class 7. Let us begin with a small activity. Children, can you form a closed figure with one matchstick? No. Can you form a closed figure with two matchsticks? One, two. No. Can you form a closed figure with three matchsticks? Let's check. One, two, three. Yes. Can you form a closed figure with four matchsticks? One, two, three, four. Yes, we got again a closed figure. So, from this activity, it is clear that a closed figure is formed with minimum three line segments. What do we call the polygon closed by three line segments? It is a triangle. Then, what is a polygon formed with four line segments called? It is a quadrilateral. The word quadrilateral is derived from Latin words quadri and latus. Quadri means four, latus means side. So quadrilateral is a four-sided polygon. A quadrilateral is a closed figure with four vertices, four sides and four angles. Let us have a look at them. This is a quadrilateral and the vertices are A, B, C, D. Let's count 1, 2, 3 and 4. And let's name them A, B, C, D. Then the sides are AB, BC, CD, DA. Angles are angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. And AC and DB are its diagonals. The line segment joining opposite vertices is called a diagonal. So AC and DB are its diagonals. Opposite and adjacent. Opposite means facing each other. Adjacent means side by side. Look at this quadrilateral. What are the opposite angles? Angle A is opposite to angle C. And angle D is opposite to angle B. The same way opposite vertices. A and C are opposite vertices. B and D are opposite vertices. Opposite sides. AB is opposite to CD. BC is opposite to AD. And vice versa. Next, adjacent angles. Angle A is adjacent to angle B and angle D. The same way, angle A and C are adjacent to angle B. And the angles D and B are adjacent to angle C. And angles A and C are adjacent to angle D. Then adjacent sides. Adjacent sides of AB are AD and BC. The same way AB and CD are adjacent to AD. AD and BC are adjacent to CD. AB and CD are adjacent to BC. Now, look at this quadrilateral, children. We have two quadrilaterals here and let us take two points in the interior and join them. We observe that in first quadrilateral, a part of line segment lies in the exterior of the quadrilateral, whereas in the second one, it is completely in the interior of the quadrilateral. So, the first figure is called concave quadrilateral and the second one is called convex quadrilateral. Next, we have angles and property of a quadrilateral. Let us take a quadrilateral and cut the four corners of it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I place them one beside the other. 1, 2, 3, 4. We observe that the four angles, when placed adjacent to each other, form a complete angle, that is 360 degrees. So the sum of four angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Here we have six types of quadrilaterals: trapezium, kite, parallelogram, rhombus, rectangle and square. Let us have a look at each of them now. First, trapezium. A trapezium is a type of quadrilateral in which one pair of opposite sides is parallel. Look at this. The side which is in red color and the opposite side, they both are parallel. The other two sides which are black in color are not parallel. Coming to properties, in trapezium exactly one pair of opposite sides are parallel and the non-parallel sides may be equal or may not be equal, and if they are equal, it is called isosceles trapezium. See here, the non-parallel sides are equal, hence it is called isosceles trapezium. Next we have parallelogram. It is a quadrilateral with two pairs of parallel sides. In this we have two pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Coming to properties, the first one is opposite sides are parallel and congruent. Look at this, opposite sides, children, they are parallel and equal. Another pair of opposite sides, they are parallel and equal. Opposite angles are congruent. Look at the opposite angles, they are equal. Another pair of opposite angles, they are also equal. Adjacent angles are supplementary. Let us place two adjacent angles side by side. We see that they form a straight angle, that is 180 degrees. Hence, adjacent angles are supplementary. Diagonals bisect each other. Look at these diagonals. One diagonal divides the other diagonal into two equal parts. See here, the two parts of the diagonal are equal. The same way, another diagonal divides it into two equal parts. Each diagonal divides the parallelogram into two congruent triangles. That means the diagonal divides into two triangles which are congruent. Next we have rectangle. It is a quadrilateral with all the four angles equal to 90 degrees. Properties: look at the opposite sides, they are parallel and equal. Same way, another pair of opposite sides, again parallel and equal. All angles are right angles. All the angles are equal to right angles, 90 degrees. Diagonals are congruent, that means the diagonals are equal and they bisect each other here also. Next, rhombus. It is a parallelogram with all the four sides having equal lengths. Coming to properties, all sides are congruent. Look here, all the four sides are equal. Opposite angles are congruent. See here, opposite angles are equal. Another pair of opposite angles are also equal. Diagonals are perpendicular to each other. The angle between the diagonals will be 90 degrees. And diagonals bisect each other here also. And adjacent angles are supplementary. Next we have square. It is a quadrilateral in which all sides are equal and angles are also equal. Properties: all sides are equal. Look here, all the four sides are equal. All angles are equal. All angles are equal and each angle is 90 degrees. Opposite sides are parallel to each other. Diagonals are equal. Both the diagonals are equal. Diagonals are perpendicular. Angle between them is 90. and diagonals bisect each other. Next we have kite. It is a quadrilateral that has two pairs of equal length sides and these sides are adjacent to each other. Properties: it has two pairs of consecutive congruent sides. Look here, these two sides are adjacent to each other and they are equal. One more, these two are adjacent and they are also congruent. It has two diagonals, we intersect at right angles. So what we have discussed, a simple closed figure bounded by four line segments is called a quadrilateral. The sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees. Coming to properties, children, all sides are equal in rhombus and square. All angles are equal in rectangle and square. And diagonals are perpendicular to each other in rhombus and square. So children, observe the things around and classify them into types of quadrilaterals you learned and note the properties you observe in them. Thank you all for watching this.